And what a lovely day it has been. Welcome back to Project Zombie Boy. It's BV once again, and we are here. Oh my goodness. Oh, I completely forgot where we left off at when I last stopped playing. We were playing Elden Ring at one point. We were dealing with Project Zombie. We found a base. That's what it is. So, and we are going to start doing some work. Now, our character is clearly tired, so I'm not going to push ourselves. Let's go ahead and get rested up real quick, and then we'll start the day. Probably should have started there, but, you know, it is what it is. PRMR, good evening, good afternoon, good morning. I see something wrong with string. I am not showing Project Zomboid. I am showing Project Zomboid. We're good. Oh, taking a look at my audio. So I think I made the adjustments that I needed to make on audio, which is good. Oh, we'll see how that lasts. I already see it's doing weird stuff. I'm not sure how I feel about it. Let's see how it goes. Anyway, it's fog outside, which I cannot stand. Goodness gracious. Okay, so plans for today or tonight's stream. I'm a little all over the place, so just to be 100% open about it, I got home from my escapades in real life about 10 minutes ago, so I'm not entirely prepared for stream, but, you know, we'll run with it. What we need to do is, one, see what it takes to get over here to West Point. Yeah, this is West Point, right? Yeah, West Point, because this is construction site. This is the nursing home location. So we do know West Point, but we're actually coming at it in a different way. So fair enough, right? I have never been in this area before, so I am curious to see it. I'm guessing, since this was all farmland, that this is nothing but farmland as well, but that also means that there should be farmsteads, various different homes that we can loot from and look at. So we're not going to waste a whole bunch of time and just wait inside. We are going to go check those places out and start getting the game going. Oh my goodness. So quick check in. Where are we at? How are we doing? Oh, Brandon Stackhouse here is doing well. We got 1,000 kills. It's 1 month in, 7 days. Working on our 8th of the month, and we're happy. We're happy. We're healthy. We're doing well. I do recall that we're still gaining weight, so yay. And pointing out the fact that we're using fruit salads and other things like that to gain calories. if we're 100% honest, it's because we started foraging for food instead of just using those base values again. So I just want to call that out as well. Thanks, you're good. Colby, what's up, dude? How's it going? I honestly had thought to pop into various different games tonight, whether it be Eve Online, whether it be Guild Wars, etc. And in truth, the only reason why I didn't do any of those things is simply because I wasn't ready. I was like in a super panic trying to get online on time. So it just came down to what's the easiest thing to pop on stream immediately with, and Project Zomboid was it. That doesn't mean we have to run the whole night on Project Zomboid, but I will be here at least for the start. Oh my goodness. As far as real life is concerned, I had the opportunity to drive a Tesla for the first time today, so that was a good experience. I do not like it. I'm just gonna put that out there. For anybody who owns a Tesla, you know, good on you, happy for you. I'm not saying anything bad about it. I don't like the auto drive feature. It kind of takes control away from me. It was not extremely responsive. We ran a red light. The reason for it, because the car, like, the light was already changing to yellow. It switched to red, and the car was like, I don't know what I'm going to do. It made the decision pretty late and then slammed on the brakes, but it was already in the middle of the intersection, so that it sped up real quick, too. It was frightening. I have no problem with saying it. It was frightening to be in the autopilot of the Tesla. Now, in a straightaway on the highway, such that it worked fine. I'm not going to say anything about that. Light traffic, medium traffic, maybe I would never drive the auto feature on like in full traffic, rush hour traffic. But that's not really what it was designed for either. So, you know, it's not It's not production. It's not like you can jump in your Tesla and be like, drive me here and then never touch the wheel. Like, there's still a level of human aspect into it, and that makes sense. But again, real life, I did have the opportunity to experience driving the Tesla. Will I buy one? Probably not. But yeah. Driving long hours. Yeah. Like, if you're driving across multiple states, for example, at a distance that your battery can handle, it makes sense. For us East Coasters, you know, just taking a moment to recognize that we have the Jersey Turnpike, for example. If you were heading to New York or heading away from New York, and the Turnpike could be an hour drive on its own. Yes, that is just fine. In heavy traffic time, how? Oh my God, I have sprinters in the save. No way. No way. This is not. We gotta go. We gotta go, go, go. Ugh, crap. And the problem is how far of a distance that goes. Oh. And that house is under construction. It's not fair. So my problem with that is a sprinter could be like running through this field right now to get to that house, and we can't see him. But at least the alarm went off. Now it's just a matter of recognizing that we're gonna have to fight at a house that's under construction. I don't see anything, which is good. I do recall when we drove here, there was a pretty large group that we drove by, though. And that's really my biggest concern at the moment. But we've had a house alarm go off before. Not necessarily in this state, but with sprinters. And, you know, we saw the sprinter booking it. And that's just the kind of the reason why I ran away, so. Because you never know how many sprinters would be over there. So, what am I doing now? I'm going to jump in the RV, drive back over to the building. I'll see how many sprinters might have come up, and if there are a bunch there, we'll just drive away. There's no other way of saying it. I don't like it because I still can't see anything, though. Like, my visibility is shot. I mean, okay. Okay. We'll go for it. If there is going to be any sprinters, they're already here. I'm just putting that one out there. Oh, I refuse not to kill any zombies that are currently here. So we will deal with that. And we'll take it easy. YOLO. Kobe, kill me, man. I mean, okay. Lucky for us, it won't happen again. Oh, this is an interesting setup. Oh, there's already a pipe wrench. We have a pipe wrench. Okay, so things that we're going to need building, you know, that other space into a base. This plaster here will work with a bucket of water and allow you to make walls, drywall. That's what I'm looking for. So these bags of plaster will turn our warehouse into a home. And then once you've done the plaster, then you can paint those walls. So this is actually a really good resource spot. Huh. Is this all wood? This is all wood. So I don't have to actually do anything with planks, which means I've got lots of flooring. I just need to be able to handle nails. And I didn't see nails when we were inside. But we definitely have solved some of our problems. I've got a trash bin over here too. This is solid. I can actually disassemble a lot of this as well to get nails and other materials. Don't run. There's part of me who's thinking to myself, like, yeah, I could use this as a frame instead of the other warehouse, but I don't like it. I don't think I'm going to do that, so. The house didn't have any water, no power, barely any walls, and yet we still had an alarm event. Yes, very true. Very true. I did have a pipe wrench. Oh, that's fair. Now, let's take a look real quick at my skills. Oh, so carpentry level 7 is something I need to work on. We need to get some books. Yeah, okay. Well, this is a good find. Let's just be honest about it, right? So I know I don't have to get out of the vehicle to walk around. I could, you know, transfer the seats. I just didn't do that. Didn't give you crap, please. All right, let's head up, see what else that we find. Couple of zombies. Any sprinters over there? Nobody but me thought about the seats. That's not true. I'm sure there's going to be some YouTuber out there who, in the comments, would be like, bro, you could have done blah, 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 blah. Good. Do you recall that we do have zombie respawning turned on? So killing the zombies, honestly, is just so I don't have to deal with them later when I come back through. But they will spawn again, and that is fine with me. Ooh. Luckily, I don't have to think about traffic. So blocking the road is fine. We find our first house. I like it. Well, I don't like the house. Actually, this is a terrible position, but yeah. Nobody. Let's check around the other side real quick. Feel pretty good about it. Poor dog. Word. Again, no dogs in the current build, but herd. Build 42 is basically delayed, so I'm calling that out real quick. Which I like Zomboid in its current state enough to where that doesn't bug me too much, but it is kind of a bummer. I mean, realistically speaking, we've been doing a lot of work so that way we could be prepared for build 42. But you know, that's not happening. There is nothing in this house, and I don't like any of the furniture in here either. So, huh. Okay, so if this road here is what I think it is, and I follow this road until I make it to town, that's basically what we got. Take a look at our nutrition. We're still managing our weight just fine, which is good. So eat some food. And question, I mean, this looks like a real road. Kinda, it's a side road. Ooh. Lots of farmland. I recognize that there are zombies in these fields. So try not to make a bunch of noise. Keep it real. Bathrooms clears and no crazy bathroom spawning. I hear a zombie though. I definitely hear a zombie. Where are you? Yep. Where you at? Are you the only one? Is the question. Open the door. Nothing. Ugh, looks good. Carpentry level 1. Crap. thinking about it, wait a minute. We already have bonuses to electrical, so it makes sense for me to disassemble the lamp. If we recall one of our previous saves with Raymond, these lamps give some great experience when it comes to our electrical skill, especially when you have your bonuses. So at 104, after you get done disassembling, it turns into 113. Not bad. All right, and hands, meat cleaver. Good. Is there anything really that we need it anymore? I know I wanted to collect more bowls so that way I can start making like large soups. So if you have four, if you have two bowls, you can split them in two. If you have four, you can split them in four. So a super cook can do a lot with one bowl of soup is kind of what I'm getting at. Which, we're a chef, and that's exactly what we're trying to get to. I know I didn't collect the bowl from the other spot. I didn't think about it at the time, but I'm thinking about it now. So, not to mention, on the way back, we can pick it up. Don't I need better short blade skill? Yes, but, you know, that's something that we have to work on by fighting. And our short blade skill now is actually above our axe skill, so we're already getting to that point. All right. Well, let's not waste any more time. It doesn't look like I can do anything else with this house. And I didn't really care for any of the stuff in there either. But I do feel like I'm thinking about this the wrong way. Oh, wait. This counts as a garage. So if I get in there and check some of the cabinets, I should be able to find some nails. I'm going to need a lot of nails for what I'm thinking about doing. So... Nothing. Fertilizer and nothing. Crap. Of course, this is not a shed. This is a barnyard. The house didn't have salt either. That is true. The house did not have salt. Okay, let's just take a look real quick. Where are we at? So this main road here probably does a turn and comes up here. I say that because this map shows a forest line right here. So this road is going to be this main road here if I follow through. So that means this other road here probably leads to another set of houses, which I don't think it hurts to take a look at since we're here. Even if we don't take anything, we have a good understanding what's around. Let's see what we can do. Currently, we're living inside the RV. Yes, the other base location, that warehouse, is not ready to go. And it's going to be a bit before it's really ready to go. Ooh. I mean, we got a truck. At the very least. All right, we kill that real quick. Let's take a look at the house. Windshield's busted, so I can't use it to replace my windshield, but house looks good. There's a TV. Anything in the truck? Let's take a look. Baseball bat. There's a pipe bomb here. I am going to take it on principle. I don't think I've ever used a pipe bomb before. I've used a firebomb before, but never a pipe bomb. I've used a smoke grenade too from the engineer profession. Again, never the pipe bomb. I feel like it's a death sentence though. So, gosh. Is anything open or I gotta break into this house? Oh God. I'm out. I feel like this is just a warning sign. It's time to go. All right, so what we're gonna do is get started on my thought process. No, I can't do it. I need to work on my carpentry skill. Okay, so let me explain. With the carpentry skill, what would happen is I could make staircase, right, to get to the second floor, then make a flooring, which let's do this real quick, carpentry, stairs. Stairs require carpentry level 6. I was wrong. I thought it was level 7. So that's true. I just need one book. I need volume 3. Or I can just super grind it out. Oh man, but what's the best way to grind out? See, these are zombie migrating towards that alarm. I'm surprised that they're all moving at a similar pace, though. Is something wrong with my mods? I feel like they're all moving at the same pace. I don't see a difference in their speed, which means there's something wrong with the random zombies. At least that's how it feels. So you're in a fight. They feel very samey. I didn't do nothing. Although if I played another save, because I've been doing some testing and I did play another save recently that has a different mod that does things to zombies. So maybe that's what's causing problems because of how it loads. Huh. I'm not getting into that right now. If tonight, you know, things are weird, fine, and I'll fix it later. But we're here, we're playing, it is what it is. All right. Definitely felt slower, yes. Nothing. Come on, man. I'm just trying to break into this house. Work with me. Let me break into this house. Perfect. He has a beard. Yes, yes, he does. I like this table. Unlike anything else about this house, but I like the table. Oh, I feel like this is a house that should have salt. I'm just gonna speak it into existence. No salt. Chocolate chips. Marshmallows. Good for camping purposes, but no salt. Books. Nothing really of use. Blah. Take a look at storage. Nothing here. I'm out. Alright, so we're gonna be grinding. That's definitely what it's looking like tonight. Oh, that's not the way I wanted to do things. So we are here. Ooh, I was wrong. This road actually ends. So I do need to go up that other road. That's interesting. Oh, I am low on water and food. I don't know why I'm saying all that, because we are in an RV. Chocolate chips can go up here. Marshmallows can go up here. Let's take a look at everything. Everything feels okay, but I am getting a little hungry. Got stale food. Let's start cooking stuff. So what are we gonna do? Gonna use those dandelions. I forgot about the fried onions. Yes. So dandelion is for my UK folk. Similar to rocket, I guess you would say, in terms of like taste. I don't think it's as bitter as rocket could be, but I'm sorry for my Americans out there, arugula. But yes, I don't think dandelion is as bitter as arugula can be, but still has a similar taste. So to mix it with like a grape leaf, which is closer to maybe a collard. Oh, I could see that working. You hear me shopping, but not the dramatic music. Are you telling me that the game mixing audio is strange? 9%. Let's take a look here. Yeah, I hear the music on stream. Okay. Oh, it's a little low in comparison to what I got going on. If you think we should pump it up, I'll bring it up there. That's about it, though. I think any higher, then it's going to get strange. Okay. Good. Yes, maybe. No. Pipe bomb. I've never actually used the pipe bomb before, though. So you quit the pipe on and then perform a basic attack to throw. That's it. Okay. Interesting. So our already eight that did worse game. Think. How many bowls do I have? I have two bowls here. I thought I already had two bowls before. Where are my other bowls at? That's gonna be my first question. Did I lose a bowl? Did I do something stupid? I feel like I did something stupid. Huh. Yeah, I'll deal with that later. It's not that deep. Let's keep moving. Draw a light bulb. Get out of here. Another day grinding. Yes. Hello, Sweet Pepper. It's been a while since I've seen you. We're doing a little bit more than just grinding. I mean, we're surviving. We're thriving. Goodness gracious. Trying to decide how to approach a issue. It had looked like this had ended. It didn't end, so that's good. So it was just the map at that point. But we are definitely heading to West Point now. Instantly thought about Breaking Bad because of the trailer. Yeah, I can see that. I can definitely see that. I hadn't thought of it until you just said it. So. Alright, we are almost to West Point. We've been pretty thorough on our journey in terms of, you know, things and places to see. I'm kind of interested in two things. If I can find myself a generator, that'd be great. And that means I don't have to go back. Like, I don't want to do too much backtracking in other towns. The other thing that'd be nice, if I could find an antique oven, that would save me a lot of headaches too. What is that? You really want to play Star Rail? I've never heard of this game before. What kind of game is it? Talk to me. Empty gas can. Metal pipe. Nice. Game. Not really working with me today, huh? Cool. I don't know what to say on this one. If you had a PC, you would try Project Zomboid. I need you to get a PC. No, that's fine. By all means, I understand that sentiment that if you ain't got it, you know, it's unfortunate, no matter how much fun a game may seem. I will say, however, that Project Zomboid... No, I don't think there's ever a time where Project Zomboid would have a true mobile version. I know that you can play it with a controller, which I'm thinking to myself, I've legitimately tried playing Project Zomboid Steam remote play on my phone with an Xbox controller in hand. It's weird because it's much different than playing with, you know, a keyboard and mouse, but it is possible. However, because of Project Zomboid's design, it just can't fit into a mobile game. You know, a lot of that has to do with its code being almost entirely Java and stuff. Okay, I think I'm gonna stop. Oh my god. All right, so this is a good test. If I don't see one sprint, yeah, I don't feel like I see anybody who is a different movement speed here. So my mods are definitely broken in some way, shape, or form. And that is a problem with mods, for sure. All right, let's not break bust up my vehicle. It's late. Yeah, it's late. I feel like what we're gonna do is we're gonna circle back. So I do have one crawler though to start with. Oh, there's a sprinter back there. I see him. Okay. So we have confirmed my mods are working just fine. I just had gotten lucky, I guess. I mean, used the word lucky previously. So we're going to drive away from town because I'm about to be like, yeah, there's still sprinters. We'll just deal with it and take the benefit tonight. Nope. Game was trying to bait me. Anti-govern. Love that right now. Yep. Warmth benefit, absolutely, even though currently we don't need to be warm. I mean, it is August 16th and it was 90 something degrees very recently. Even still, now we know where we are. Now we know how far we have to go to get to West Point. I think we're not going to go all the way back to the other building. I need to make some decisions. Double back to real quick because I want to see what's on this road. The game wanted us to get comfortable. Yes, it did. Yes, it did. But we're moving too close to nighttime. And we've done a little bit of walking around. We haven't done a bunch of fighting. And the short blade doesn't use a lot of endurance. But we still would get tired. And that's going to affect our damage and so on and so forth. It's just a bad luck. Yeah, see, we're already tired. So that's not a good thing to walk into. Oh, my God. There's a trailer there, though. I wonder the condition of that trailer. I want to deal with this. I want to do this. But how did y'all get into this? Like, did... I mean, if y'all gonna let me just walk out. Y'all just gonna let me walk up. I'll do it. I'm clearly feeling confident, and I realized that that was stupid. There is no way for me to know that any of them were or were not sprinters, and just one sprinter would have turned that into a weird fight. I need to rethink what I'm doing, man. Okay, let's do this real quick. So you can check the condition of a trailer. And the condition of this trailer is terrible. Oh, 9%. Goodness gracious. So if I use this trailer, it will bounce and I will drop things quite often. All right. My metalworking skill isn't in a position yet to start repairing that either. But I will remember that it's here. Can I get around you? I can just drive through the field, can I? I can just drive through the field, yeah. Or, you know what? We don't drive through the field yet. Let's get inside the car. Take a look at the map. Okay, so this is now complete. And we know this will take us into town. We didn't get into town. Once you hit this, you've got zombies. Lots of zombies that you're going to fight through. I don't know why. There is a warehouse here. That's why. Well, it'll be a nice stream, so on and so forth. I'll be back. All right. So, cheers, man. If you don't make it back, have a wonderful evening. If you do, I look forward to seeing you. I understand long work days. I definitely do. How do I feel like? So we're going to make a food stew. There it is. Lay off the beans. Nah, we're gonna use the beans. Thanks so much. Take care. Cheers. Black beans. Bullion cube. Chives. Crackers. This is sounding a lot like something I made this weekend. So, but I use black beans and kidney beans, so I'm just gonna do it for good measure here. Wouldn't have put any grape leaves in something like this. If I would slice, no, but with chives, there's no reason to add leek. Because I don't use leek to fill out the dish. Mushrooms, that's definitely a thing. I use dried shiitake in mine though. So just to give it like a meaty, nice texture. Add a little bit of onion to it. Uh-huh. And then... So the tomato paste is a seasoning game, unfortunately enough. But if you look at these ingredients, you tell me, what is this? It says stew, but it's not really a stew, right? If you put beans, mushrooms, onions with chives, tomato paste, and crackers into a pot and let them boil, what do you get? Just a question for my viewers. It. Yeah, pop that into the oven. If you're stumped by the answer on this, go over that again. We're just talking about the ingredients, right? So if you were to stick black beans, kidney beans, crackers, onions, mushrooms, chives, a bouillon cube, and tomato paste into a pot and boil it with water, what does that turn into? Obviously spices in general, right? But what is that really, if you really think about it? Mushy? No. Soup. You guys are killing me. It's a chili. Those are the base ingredients of chili. Right, yes. Oh, I did have another bowl. I was right, I'm not crazy. Now, of course, for my meat eaters out there, when you stop and think about it, if you added, you know, a block of ground beef in there, yeah, you get, it's a straight chili. But again, the whole point was just pulling out the ingredients. You guys know I'm a weird chef type person. What now? Anyway, do we sleep now and be prepared for the fight? Or do you know what? No, I remember we've been working on our weight. I don't have space to work out currently because we're still not in a stable situation with our base. Otherwise, I'd be working on fitness. But I also need to work on sprinting if I think about it. If I'm going to outrun sprinters, I need to get to sprinting level 3, if I recall. Oh, considerations. But one thing I haven't done for a while is just lie down on the bed, man. And then we'll go to sleep. In game or real life? I was thinking, oh, in game. I've definitely laid down plenty in real life. Now you're saying refried beans. Well, refried beans, in order to do that, let's say you did take a dried bean that you need to hydrate with water, and you want to turn that into refried beans. You don't need anything other than water, the beans themselves to cook them down or make them soft. And then you need potato starch. If you look at any... like packaged refried beans, what you'll typically find is potato starch is going to be mixed in there. It's really just how much. Do you want it in a can, for example, because that potato starch will help it set, or do you want it to be a block? So in certain different grocery stores, you'll find that you can get a block of refried beans, and then you can just hydrate it and you've got your beans, right? It's just how much potato starch was used to dry it out and turn it there. Did I miss slop? Why did I get slop? You're killing me. Oh, no. And we answered the question that one. It's not slop. It is chili. What we made. We are still working on weight. Putting that in there. Yes, fill cooking pot. I know, Project Zomboid player talking about cooking chili and recipes. Sorry. All right. I will feel like I should make something. Chili's good. Yes, chili is very good. I mean, number one, not everybody's chili is good. Let me be clear about that real quick. Some of y'all don't know how to make no chili. And it really does come down to spices, not necessarily what you put in there. So I say that very clearly because I've had lots of weird chilies before. Same thing with, what's the word I'm thinking of? Curry. Curry is something that is very easy to turn into whatever you want to. So long as you have the right spices and balances, you'll be fine. So if you decide that you want to make a chocolate curry, you can. If you decide that you want to add strawberries into a curry, you can. There are a list of things that you can do with curry if you understand how to balance your spices. And that same thing is true for chili. The only difference between them is presentation, right? Curry is supposed to be thick-ish. Laid on your bed of rice and various different things popped inside. Chili, virtually the same thing, but thicker, and usually you want it to be extremely hearty. It should be able to stand on its own without another starch. So it's kind of one of those things where it's like, usage and area of the world is where it comes into play. But my big thing is, you know, a chili can be good or bad based on what you put in it. Oh, it has nothing to do with the actual food. It has everything to do with the spices. And if anybody gets hungry, please tell me to shut up. Or go get some food. I mean, just put that out there too. All right, let's get moving. Oh, what just happened? That's not good. My vehicle shut off on its own. Chili's one of your favorite things, so that's good. Anything with beans, you're a fan, that's fair. Oh, my battery's running low. Actually, the engine is why the shut off though, but my battery's at 27%. Oh, battery situation is gonna be a problem. I just realized how much I'm like burning the batteries on the RV. Cause I feel like this is my third battery I'm on. Now I'm gonna switch there. Went to take a look what was on this road other than this car. It doesn't seem like there's anything. So we're going to get in the car, the RV, and I'm not going to go through here. What I am going to do, I'm trying to think of the best way to do it. I haven't decided if I'm going to do the super like drive into town really crazy and fast, make it to the bookstore, jump in the bookstore, grab the book that I want and then leave, like get out of Dodge. Or do we go slow and steady wins the race? Or we can avoid all of that, because realistically speaking, we don't need the books. What we do need to do, though, is work on the skills. And it could take the exact same amount of time to do what I'm thinking in the first place. So, I think what we do is go ahead and head back to the warehouse. I'm not risking it right now. I'm not risking it right now. Like, even if we weren't with the DRV, we have almost every item we need to truly make a base. It won't look pretty to start with, but we're almost there. So I think I'm not going to press my luck. You know, it is Sunday and we are notoriously dying on this channel on Sundays. So let's, you know, break the trend and head back to base. out and get started with the safe way of getting ourselves set up. I think the biggest issue is going to be how do we upgrade, get our carpenter skill high enough, right? I think that's really our biggest issue. Two levels. Can it be done? Yes, I know I can't drive. I'm not using Sunday Driver right now, which is my normal way of doing this. All right, so what I want to do is essentially commit to disassembling everything in this place. If I do that, let's see how much we get. Take everything out of these crates. Anything that's in them gets dropped on the floor. We'll take all the stuff that's on the floor later and place it somewhere that makes sense. But for now, the entire point is for us to start hoping for the best in terms of disassembling these crates. Not to mention the amount of screws that we potentially could get, but the disassembly is going to go very far for our skills. That's the whole point. So we're at 385. Let's see how many we get out of that. Oh, it's not much. It's only three. We're only going to get one level out of this, it looks like. But you know what? Let's... don't watch paint dry. Come on. Just get to it. So we're going to skill build now. Yes. We're going to skill build as much as we can. At least in this case. We already needed to clear this area because this is going to be our garage space, right? My intention is to make a floor plan of this warehouse that makes sense. The first part of that means an area where we can work on cars. Or at least store cars. The RV can fit on one side, whereas any other cars would fit on the other. And that means that I would put a wall probably right after this window. So there's a window here. We do one more tile and then line. And this line goes all the way across. From there, you have the other side of the house. And I'm going to have a staircase that goes up. Because you can't, there is a second floor up here, but you can't get there because there's no staircase. So I'm going to build a staircase. Bottom floor will be storage in the back, maybe living room, dining room, / kitchen down here. At the top, we'll put the bedroom, effectively. And yeah, we're going to build a base. That's kind of the point. All right. Which actually means that, you know, life is going to be pretty simple. We're going to be doing lots of speeding. So conversation topics will go a long way. Good luck on this run. Thank you, Sweet Pepper. All right, so we do that. Disassemble the tables. I don't know why I'm doing 2x speed. I can do 3. Yes, there we go. And we've already secured this space in the sense that we put those logs. Okay, so, well, this makes me think of manual labor moving somewhere else. Yes. Kind of what's going to happen here, so. And after we did that, another thing that I have to think about is this place doesn't have lights, really. I wonder. I haven't seen a light switch. Hang on. No light switch. Keep it going down. I don't see any light switches on these walls at all. This building doesn't have a natural light switch available to it. So even if the power was on, you wouldn't be able to just like click a switch and lights turn on, which means that I have to put a bunch of lamps in this place and collect a bunch of light bulbs. Yeah, it's part of the game. But if we take a look at the skill, oh god. Yeah, we'll never get there. Not like this. Man, I gotta rethink this a little bit. I wanna see something real quick. Technically, you get carpentry experience when you saw planks as well. For those of you who live in the woods in game. All right, so we're at 415. I saw one set that turned into nothing. Hold on. Let's do it one more time. Just for the test, because I didn't look at the point something. 0.97. Yeah, it does go up. It's not by much. Oh, man. I'd have to knock down a bunch of trees, mass deforestation to get that. That's not going to work. It is better to go into town and fight. Oh, man. Okay. The game is giving me no choice. Well, let's be prepared then. I mean, if we had to deal with that way, we do it that way. So, condition is now. Let's take a look. I'm not worried about condition. It's more remaining than anything else that I need. So, let's get the vehicle in a good space. Are we gonna head to town? We're gonna head that direction for sure. Oh, clear as much as we can as we go. So this is interesting. I got remaining 28% instead of 24%. Does this thing like recharge while I drive? Interesting. I'm gonna leave that alone. What do we hope to find in town? In truth, all we need is a Carpentry Volume 3 book. If I can find the Volume 4 as well, I will take it, but we need that to happen. Like I mentioned before, I can always double back. We've done a lot of driving. So I can always double back this direction, right? And then try to work my way down. But the bookstore here in Muldra is down here. And it's crazy dangerous to try to fight through this. No matter how you look at it, it's no fun to try to fight through. There's no bookstore in the Dixie shop, so that's unfortunate. This intersection is great, but again, no bookstore. I believe this is the school, so we'd actually be driving into town off of this main road. We'd be pulling into the school, but you have no idea how many zombies are right here. And if you recall, back from Raymond, West Point is heavily populated. There are a bunch of zombies that are just over here for no apparent reason. So it's not safe. The best thing to do is get as close as we can and then like park the RV. Try to hoof it, make it inside the school, find the books that we need, and then leg it. But that it's no matter how you look at it, it's a fight. Oh, and we're gonna do a lot of fighting. But it's way more efficient to have those skill bonuses than to not have those skill bonuses. Do we have the gas to make that trip? Yes, we have plenty of gas. I'm pretty sure I have 4 gas cans in the trunk. And then, of course, pretty much a full tank right now. So I'm not concerned about gas. I am concerned about, you know, the RV itself potentially becoming damaged to the point where I can't move it. That would be a death sentence, I feel like. So, like I said, the whole point is for us to get as close as we can. We'll base up for the night inside the RV, pop out, kill zombies, move up, so on and so forth. But yeah, we're not going to sit around for the next 3 weeks in game trying to get enough experience when I can just go get the book and it would save us multiple days worth of time. I think this is about where we start. We should park. Yeah, this is it. Double check. Map says we're almost there. Actually, no. I like to have some distance. All right, put that away. Grab the meat cleaver. What is that? I've never heard that sound in game before. Like straight up gunfire. Nothing? All right. Oh man. Goodness, I hate sprinters in this game. I'm saying that, silly, it's not a shot on you. It's still a way that I don't think I'll ever play without sprinters again. Oh, but still, it is nerve-wracking. Wonder if the noise is because of sprinters. No, it's probably the random zombies mod that, you know, does different event sounds. Okay. So let's deal with our first set and see what we get. But yeah, definitely wouldn't want to drive the RV into this. I want to be able to control engagements as much as we can. Oh, so if we had to take it slow, we take it slow. Well, it'd be great if you can do more one-shots like that. Oh man. When you start killing these zombies in less than, you know, three. Perfect. All right, combat's looking good for the night so far. Hi. Hello. Neither of you could have been sprinters. Down you go. All right. Let's get it. Do I feel good about this? No, I don't. I feel like I'm moving very slow already, but again, safe than sorry. And you never know when you're gonna run into a sprinter. God, look at the groups around here. Hi. Any sprinters? Slow, regular mover, blah, no sprinters. Okay, that's good. We are currently fighting to get to West Point. That's the important thing to point out. Oh, so game. Got him. Are you all regular? He's loving happiness, dude. Oh no. What happened there? Come on. Doing okay. They do have different textures? Yes. Yes, they do. on, come on. Oh, missed. Uh-oh, ankle biter. Good to go. Now I know for sure, last time I was here, I saw a sprinter, which is actually what caused me to turn around. If I hadn't seen that one sprinter, I wouldn't have turned. Good. So sprinter is gonna be over here somewhere. There it is. There it is. Come on. That doesn't mean there aren't other sprinters around. I just knew that I had seen one, so. Order, it's not order up. It's so intense. Okay. I'm going to point out that we are not tired at all, but that's mostly because we've been using the short blade. So, if you like something that can let you swing for days, short blade is it. It's just not easy to level, and it doesn't do a ton of damage. At least at low levels. So, object. Oh, and now I said that, and now we're moderately exerted. Oh, leveling, yes, is easier because we are a chef, so, yeah. Other than that, you know, you use the same amount of endurance every time you make swings, so, yay. But, every time you gain levels, you use less endurance per swing. So at level 10, you basically are walking. I mean, when you swing, so, yeah. Whereas the axe, even at level 10, you're still swinging a two-handed axe, so you will get tired much quicker. All right, let's get back to the RV. Like I said, we caused plenty of death and destruction, so now we'll move up a little bit more and then start the process over again. Now, maybe the reason why I put the RV in the spot that it did is because I felt like if I had to run away for some reason, I'd be able to break line of sight, jump in the RV before being seen by the zombie again, and then teleport. Like, that was honestly why I did it the way I did. We always handle axes with two-handed. No, there's a one-handed axe as well, which you've seen us use a couple times. Oh, I say a couple times, a lot of times. But it still uses more stamina than a standard knife. All right, how we doing? We're doing good. We're doing good. So this was the bend. Everybody saw me? We're good. We're good. I just like to control the engagement, as I say. No spreaders there, which looks great to me, so we fight! Come on, man. Chop him. Taking leg? No, he didn't turn into a crawler. Run. No, thank you. Game. That got weird. Okay, so across this corner, two more groups, and then I think we'll call it on fighting. I'm actually surprised we haven't leveled up yet. Oh, we're getting tired. Crap. Like, as in sleepy tired, mind you. Okay, I said two more groups. Yeah, this group needs to go before we call it a night. One, because I just... Sprinter. Naruto runs Sprinter 2 in that dress. Girl, get it. Break your face. Hits does it take? Alright, slow one's annoying me. Let's back up a little bit. Can I get there? Yes, I can. Are you the devil? Yes, yes I am. And I've come for your souls. Missed. Alright, oh. Come to your senses. How about you come to yours? Okay, I think we're good. I think we're good. Oh, so last time we'd be killed, like I said, I think I'll pull the vehicle over here to this driveway and then move forward. Scary movie thing for a monster to say, indeed. Which is why I put that mod in there in the first place, just to give the zombies a little more spice. Oh, yeah. A little bit of RP elements, etc. We good? I think we're good. Do I feel good about what has transpired? No. I've killed so many zombies. Ah, my fellow men and women who have been changed forever. We've lost them. I can't even give them proper burials because that would just take too long. Like I said, we'd be pulling it here and... Nice digs. Just take a small break. See somebody busted out of that window. Nothing's after us. So, let's pull up the map. I'll do it here just for fairness. Yes. Okay, so in the morning, we will cut around this corner, head about here. This is what I'm thinking of. And, oh my goodness, I remember where we are now. Back in Raymond's safe, we would drive from the, construction site here all the way downtown to make it to these farms, and we would do some foraging here and come back. So I know exactly where I am now. I never made it to this house, but that's okay. Yeah, I've been seen. Can't enter. There are zombies nearby. Deal with the zombies. Must be that guy. Ooh, party bus. Well, party house and stuff. What kind of party were y'all having? I'm just curious. I'm not allowed it? Alright, well, y'all figure that out. I'll wait. Y'all beat on that. I'll be over here. Can I go this way instead? Exclusive member party only? Yeah, I agree. I mean, they got the white hats, which in itself is a concern. It's almost broken. There it is. Tinfoil hats, indeed, indeed. Although I think these are paper, but you know. as far as the game is concerned. Oh, I missed. Good. We're good. Books. Maybe the game will give me what I need before we even get where we're going. I will always take pickles because they last forever in game. I'll take tomato paste because we did use some in the last chili. And then books. Yeah. I don't think I need anything here, so that sucks. Could have been useful. Okay. Didn't protect them from the virus. Indeed, it did not protect them from the virus. Okay. Not bad. They had tomato paste. They definitely had tomato paste. Oh, my peach is rotten officially. This is actually interesting. I'm looking at this right. Well, hang on a sec. The game technically would tell me that I, because of the level of my cook, could use those peaches. I'm not going to, though. So. Hunger. Thirst. Yes, drink the juices of those rotten peaches. You could do that. Or I could just dump them and never use them. Alright. Back into the RV. Yes, after all of that fighting, he's rather tired. And that is fair. What's for the night? Are we losing weight? No. Take a look at our nutrition. We're okay on calories. We're okay. I'm not going to do anything crazy. Let's make a basic. Say basic. Nothing about what I do is basic. Anyway. We can get interesting and do a pasta. Rice. I don't think I've ever made a rice bowl, have I? Let's make a rice dish. Let's just see what it turns out to be like. All right. Place rice in crock pot. I said crock pot. Cooking pot. Already did that. Can I take the... Prepare rice. There it is. Well, what would you do? This is interesting. Red beans and rice. I think red beans in the U.S. are not kidney beans, though. So I don't think I have the right beans to make a red beans or rice. Anyway, I'll use black beans. Leek. What else would I do in this scenario? I feel like this is going to turn like into a stir fry. The stir fryer, I don't know, Chinese rice. That's not much you can do with rice. Hold on, wait a minute. Is rice that heavy? In game? It's 59 hunger, it's not that heavy at all, no. Let's see what happens when I cook it and then eat it. Since hoarders usually don't use the stuff that they have claimed for emergencies, I wonder if still in an apocalypse would say it isn't an emergency. I mean, I think that anybody who has sentimental value around certain items, no matter what the scenario is, can find themselves not utilizing said sentimental items. It's unfortunate and doesn't always make the most sense, but it does happen. All right. Okay, so he scooped out the bowls of rice, and then I get it now. That's still a lot of hunger, though. Okay, so we eat one of them, right? Hang on. Show nutrition. I want to see what this bowl of rice turns into when we eat it. So, 100 calories to... 600? It's just straight rice, huh? So another six. That's solid amount of food right there. Okay. Okay. Well, Gonna let some time pass just so I can get closer to extremely tired. Very tired. There it is. And then we sleep. There we go. What just happened? Her buttons. Well, Wreck-It Rad. What's up, dude? Well, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you hanging out for the evening and whatnot. I say the evening, if you're not aware, we are East Coast streamers in the United States. So, it is nighttime, and I know that we have to work tomorrow, or at least I do. So, all right, get some hot bottled water going. Fill the cooking pot. And let's get going. I'm going to take the bowl of rice with us. I'm going to keep the pickle too. Got a stale lemon, so I'm going to bring that as well. I'm going to use those mushrooms before they start turning. So let's go. I do look like an axe murderer, don't I? Like, goodness gracious. Maybe the white shirt wasn't the best pick, but you know, it is what it is. Exit. Okay. So my issue now is I know the amount of zombies that can be on this road, and it really starts over here. But that also means that I can bring the RV right up to about here, if I remember correctly. This house here is kind of a farmhouse, and then I can use that as my spot. So it's going to get weird. Still go find a new shirt. Yes, yes, we can. But remember, sorry, the goal, specifically our goal, is to get our hands on... Oh, that's a sprinter. I need to deal with him. I don't want sprinters to become a thing. Like, do not group up. Oh! Missed the swing. Okay. We always deal with sprinters first. If you see a sprinter, you don't want to, like, drive a few blocks and then have five or six sprinters become a group. That is just death. Okay, we made it. Could have been worse. Could have been worse. Anyway, like I was saying, our super focus right now is just to get our hands on the... Words, darn it. The carpentry books. Thank you. It is not lost on me that the status of my battery keeps running lower and lower. So, that is a thing, but that's only because of how the RV is designed for balance purposes. You use the battery for your power, for your home, instead of a generator, and that's just the way the game works. I did pull a bunch of zombies, huh? Again, like I said, we're super focused on, I'm saying super focused. Try not to create groups behind me because this is still my escape route when I want to get out of here. So we deal with them as we can. Anyway, get those books. We're going to do that today for sure. Or die trying. Good. Yep. Okay. Oh, jeez. Oh, man. No. There's no way. There's no way. I see one sprinter already. Oh, no. Game, you didn't have to do this to me. Yeah, that house is no good. Look at how many zombies I would have to kill to make that happen. Oh my god. Okay. Alright. So I've definitely overshot. I was afraid of this. Okay, what do I do? What do I do? Let's do this. Get the moving. Okay. All right. Put myself in a situation where, oh my goodness, not here. No. See, I saved the axe for a reason, so. Okay. Misfit, what's going on? I am in the thick of it, so please forgive me. Yep. All right, this is where we wanted to be. I asked for this. I asked for this. All right, we're inside. Dear God. Well, like I said, I did say that we'd make it here. We made it here. I am going to do it. I'm going to do it. Pause. Yeah. I know that laugh was not the greatest thing in the world, but this is a thing that you can do, and we're going to do it. We are taking this liberty. I have sprinters, darn it. So I refuse to hear anyone's disdain about what I'm doing at the moment. You will deal with it. Anyway, we're good. There's only one magazine. Seriously? Okay, 100 magazine. I'll take it anyway. Even though we don't use that stuff in game. No. Electronic magazine, yes. No. Carpentry, no. Engineering, read it already. Don't care. Carpentry, volume 2. I need volume 3. And then good cooking, we're already right, because guess what, we're a chef. No, already read, don't need it. Game, I just need carpentry, level 3, volume 3. Please give it to me. There it is. Oh, thank you. You said the ass nicely, huh? Okay. I have about a working with volume 1 there. I might as well grab volume 2 just in case. Is there a 3 available? If I can find carpenter level 4, I might as well take that too. So. Nope. I don't see it. Did we make it? That's the problem now, right? Carpentry level 4 would be nice. Volume 4 would be nice, but that doesn't seem like it's happening. Volume 4. Oh, spoken into existence. Thank you, Brock Zomplin. Now, how hard are you going to make me work to get out of here? Is the question. Let's play. Come around real quick. This does give me a level security, so we're gonna get full on some rice. We're gonna eat it right here in the dark. And just keep our head literally on a swivel. Alright. And let's get out of here. That's the next thing. Get back to the RV and get out of here. The safest way to do this is probably to go through this door here. Oh, look at those zombies over there. Lots of decent spawns around. Gotta go. I hear beating already. Gather and retreat. Yes, I don't usually like doing things like that. Oh, sprinter. Ooh, come get it. Come get it. Yeah, lady. You know, as much as I was enjoying the meat cleaver, there's something very satisfying about taking an axe to somebody's face. What is this? Is that just a light or does it count as a generator? I've always been curious about this thing. I know there's a mobile generator in game. What are you? It does connect generator. So this is a generator and we're grabbing it. If I can get it to move out there. That's the sprinter. Please die. All right, I need to clear this. There's no way I'm gonna try to move that and hook it up right now. Let's make this safe. So, once again. Stop us? Yeah, I got you, bro. No worries. I don't think we've effectively hitched anything to this yet. So the question is going to be, can it be done? See a sprinter. Oh, come on. Run into the axe. And you two are definitely here, so let's deal with that too. Crap. One. Two. Buckle my shoe. Three. Oh no. I was very concerned about turning it on and attracting a bunch of attention, and it's just. Ugh. Does anybody remember Left 4 Dead? You know, Left 4 Dead, you always have the scenario at the end where you have to turn on something, it makes a bunch of noise, and you have to deal with a massive horde of zombies. That's how I'm feeling right now. Oh, imagine all of these zombies being sprinters. Okay, now then, how do I get you out of there? That kind of worked. Not the way I really wanted it to, but you know. Okay, so the question is, can this be attached? I don't think it can be. Game. Oop. There is a zombie that arms. No good windshield. It's not the time to worry about windshield. We're gonna get this generator. That's what we're about to do. Trying to think of my next solution to my problem. I mean, in truth, I think I caused this. And I just think it's a matter of getting the RV in the right position. But that might not be easy to do. Hello, first time here. Yes, I see you. I see you. Oh, man. Game. And then it died? How do we get you out of there is the question. Or is it just lost cause? I suppose it's fair for me to do that, right? Okay, let's do this real quick. Trying. What? Try trapping the trailer in the bottom right corner. Maybe that. Yes. So that's exactly what I was thinking of, but the thing doesn't give me a lot of space to do it. And I don't want to bust up our trailer. So, hoping that one of these vehicles have some gas. And if it does, then I can use that vehicle to bust it up. Did so much work to actually get our RV in good standing condition. Yeah, so this is the amount of space that you need to hitch something. So, I knew that. And it was just a matter of, you know, getting it attached. The Spiffle's van looked like it was in great condition, though. Smashing it! Swap seats to number one. No keys. Unlock all, please. Can I hotwire? I can hotwire. Usually when a vehicle is in this good of a condition, you get gas. Ah! Wait, game. No, I don't want to like destroy the condition of this thing. There it is. All right, so that should be good enough, right? Now the question that I have is, one, can this work for you? It can. Interesting, wait a minute, enter. Oh my God. The Spiffles van has stuff in it. I didn't know you could do that. It's hilarious. All right. I do this. You just can't get to it from it here. Interesting. So you could live in the back of a van. All right, let's shut you off real quick. No, I need to move you. I mean, a zombie could always wait. No, so that's still part of the mod. So similar to how, you know, our RV has a remote location that you're technically teleporting to. Same thing is going to happen with the van. You know, you're going to teleport to another location. So the zombies don't really know that you're in the back of the van. Oh, again, not a feature that I'm trying to use. So the RV is one thing, but not the van. Okay, so the question is, can you attach to the RV? If you can, we're golden. If you can't, we're screwed. I can, yes. Game. All right, generator. So RV, generator. This has been a successful night, yay. Well, let's say that when we get back to the base. Because now we get to do looting runs. If we have a generator for our base, we have the RV. We have our books. We have a lot of zombies there. No thank you. No thank you. I'm sorry. You're right. I don't belong here. Bye-bye. This is not the right town for me. Oh, my goodness. We're good. We're good. Come on. Let's do it, George. Really? That's how I feel. Really? Sprinter? He just threw himself right into my stuff, man. So is George the RV? I don't know. I was just kind of what I ran with for the moment. Oh, goodness gracious. George has done so much for us. George is now the RV. That's the RV name. That is a sprinter for you. Goodness gracious. Didn't I kill a bunch of zombies? No, I'm in the wrong spot. I apologize. There we go. Here are the people that I've killed. There are sprinters around. Lots of sprinters around. And this is why we chose our base to be all the way out here. So now that we have our books, you know, literature, reading materials available, we have a generator, a big generator, which I did not expect to find. I don't know how much gas it takes. It's going to be an interesting question. I'm sure if I know code modding, the way this would work is it probably listed as a regular generator. The question is capacity for how much, like, how many gallons of gas you can put inside of it. So would have found it early in the save where power is still on, that could fill the... Oh my goodness. I just thought of something. If we drive back to the Dixie Trailer Park, then that technically would do it, right? Hang on. Battery charger. You can put batteries in here to be charged too. Oh my goodness. Gas tank remaining. There it is. So, small gas tank. Interesting. This thing has an engine too. When it's running, that makes sense. So, I still would have to repair it with engine parts. But if I can keep it in good condition, I can charge the batteries as well. That actually puts me in an interesting position. Wait. Am I crazy? Hold up. Let's take a look. I am going to take, let's say you. You. And then we do this. And then we do this. Insert battery. Nope. Insert battery. Nope. Insert battery. Nope. That doesn't work. So I don't know what type of battery this requires. Well, we'll take. But that's not a big deal. In truth, you know, I was grasping at straws in that one. Oh, yeah. It would be nice, though, if the generator would autonomously, you know, charge a car battery for you. Because if that was the case, that, oh, it's regular batteries, isn't it? If I took, where's my light bulb? My hand torch. And then remove hand torch. Nope. Remove battery. And then take this battery and stick it in there. Let's take a look. That battery. Yep. So if you insert regular battery, what happens is going to be the question. I'm curious. But it says battery charger, so we'll see. Next up is gas cans. So let's see how much gas I get in one of these. We did this and we add gasoline to it. Now, a normal generator, one gas tank will give you 80%. So I'm curious to see what this actually gives us. Battery, it gave me 100%, but I was at one before already. So no, it still is interesting. So I don't know. I'm very interested in this. I also thought about something else real quick. Sound like a dad with the latest new gadget. Said, thank you. that's definitely not a bad thing. So, Okay, wait. So, I can uninstall this, and then it can be repaired after. So, you can actually repair the gas tank. Okay. And then this recharges while the engine is running, drains. So here's the interesting part, right? I don't know how that's going to work out. My original thought just now was if I took this generator back over to the Dixie trailer park, because we have a gas station set up there, we can turn on the small generator there, turn on the pump, fill this thing, but it got full in one gas tank. So now it's a question of how long would it run connected to the facility. And the other problem with that, though, is I don't have anything really to power inside of the facility right now. We just got ourselves a generator. That's it. No more, no less. nothing real interesting about it. I don't have an oven. I don't have a refrigerator. I could start gutting the RV. If I take the refrigerator out of the RV and then stick it into the spot. But I'm not going to do that. No. What am I going to do? I have a thought. What if I go back to the RV that was busted? If you recall, again, back to that, you know, Dixie Trailer Park, there is a busted RV back there that we decided we could not take because it would just be too much work to try to put back together. Instead, what we could do is gut it, you know, take the appliances out of it. And no, that doesn't make any sense because I can just go to one of the other houses here. Oh, gosh. Okay. It had a single bed. Yes. I'm not really worried about the bed situation at the moment. I don't have a problem with jumping in the RV to sleep. Okay. I'm trying to get this. I'm going to push the generator back here to this corner. So that way, one, no matter what the loudness is, it's behind the facility. And then two, being central to the facility means it should reach all tiles associated to it. It's kind of my thought process. If I can learn how to back a vehicle trailer up properly, it's not something I do in real life either, so. Granted, in real life I can drive, I'm not using sad W keys, so. Yeah, alright. Come on. I don't think I'm doing too bad. Okay, that was bad. I said those words and then I started doing dumb stuff. Come on, push it back. Ugh, game. I know, this is terrible. Don't give me crap. For those of you on stream who are legitimately watching me trying to shimmy this in the back, I appreciate you for like not hating on me immediately, but I know how bad this looks. And it's not like I can control my speed very well either in this game, so. Alright, just go back. Take it back. Alright, there it is. Just go back. Yes. Aha! I got you this time. It's almost there. It's honestly probably perfect in terms of tiles, but it's not perfect in terms of look. Nope. Just go slow. There it is. Almost there. I will take that. Okay. I'm judging in silence. Kobe. Don't do that to me. Funny enough, in real life, I feel like I would not have a problem with that. In game, I can't look at my mirrors and work the steering wheel. Oh. Okay. There you go. We definitely got it done. So. And we connect. In real life and in game, I would not be able to do it. That's fair. I mean, you know, I got you. Okay, so how does this work? Is it always going to be radio menu? Yes. Disconnect, start generator info. Look at that. All right. And then it's just a matter of getting this thing repaired. So it is considering the condition of this generator based on this overall conditioner. Because it said 39%. Nope, that's not right. It's based on the engine. Oh, no. Well, at least I have the mechanics skills to make that work. So what we should do is repair, just like we repaired our engine. So we'll just be collecting some engine parts to make sure that stays in good condition. That's what that's going to look like. That's okay. I can live with that. But I mean, if we put it all together, we got the job done. I have no idea of any other way to say it, but we got the books that we came to get. Oh, we went to get. Oh, we got a generator, which was not originally on the list, but it worked out for us, right? And we got other items, you know, that will get us through. Yeah, and cannot be mad. Just start reading through our mags. Just knock out all the literature real quick. At least the easy stuff to knock out. Oh, man. So what do we feed this man? I mean, he deserves something, right? You know, it's not just going to be a salad. Oh, yeah. Bread. Bread. Fair enough. Fair enough. I can make bread. We do have some yeast. It's been a minute since we made bread. So let's make some bread. We're going to make a bread dough, though, so we can slice that bread dough into sandwiches, maybe. Because I have a ton of mushroom, right? I got mushrooms, I got onions, I got fried onions. Yeah, I've got 20 mushrooms in there. Now, the difference between, you know, if you don't already know, the bread dough that looks like a baguette and then the standard round dough is this dough here you can put other stuff into. So chives, various other different, you know, fruits, veg, chocolate, so on and so forth, and then slice it. This one is just sliceable. You can eat the baguette directly or slice it. Why does that matter? They are literally the same recipe. Like, I want everybody to be clear on that if you are trying to figure out what the difference is. From a calorie perspective, they're the same as well. The only difference is the baguette bread does not have the ability to add anything to it, though this one does. So if you like making custom breads, or if you just want to increase the value, nutritional value of those individual slices, the regular bread dough is better to work with. Oh, that's just kind of what I'm going to throw out there. I do also believe that they come from different magazines, but once you know them all, if you know them all like we do in our character, it doesn't matter. So we're going to make some chocolate bread just because, again, we're going to pack it full of stuff. Chocolate and oregano does not work. I will tell you that now. I've tried it, but chocolate and sage does. Sage does have a good sweetness to it as far as things are concerned. Adding a bit of jam to it, and now that is a fruit bread. All right. We will cook that. Oh, another thing I want to point out, though, is you only get 2 layers. If I remember correctly, when it comes to cooking. So let's say that this 49 hunger bread gets sliced into three bread slices. What'll happen is it'll divide it by 3 for whatever the actual number comes out to be at the end. And those are your hunger values, but it's not actually your nutrition values anymore. So if you just eat those slices of bread, it will tally up. But once you turn it into a sandwich, it will no longer tally up for calorie density. So I'm just putting that out there for calories. That is not true for hunger, though. For hunger, it'll still tally up. So slicing it, you're good. It would divide this to be what? 21 hunger per slice, which let's prove that real quick. Slice the bread. And, oh, look at that. 21 hunger each. Yay. But if I turn this into a sandwich, or a burger, etc., the hunger value will stay. The calorie value when you eat the bread slices will not. So that's the thing. I'm going to eat one straight out just because we are hungry. Take a look at our nutrition. We're at negative values. That's not good. Oh, there we go. Yes. nuts would be good in it too. Yes, but we need to do some foraging to get nuts if that's what we're gonna do. Burgers. So I am gonna make, oh yeah, put some fried onions with some hot sauce and marinara, and then we'll throw a couple of different mushrooms in there. Yep. And then if I have space, dandelions. Now, if you stop and think about it, this is a legit vegan burger. Oh, mushroom burger, right? With a little bit of marinara sauce and hot sauce. But this is a very solid dish, honestly. Scrumptious. All right, so our burger is ready for us. The man gets to eat a burger. And nice and full. Perfect. All right, so we're gonna throw our other bread slice in here real quick. We'll make another burger tomorrow. Pickles. Condiments are up here. I believe I had a set of pickles up here already. Yep, we're all set. Okay, let's get our reading down so that way we can work on our carpentry skill. Am I on times 3 speed? Yep. All right, so it's midnight. Let's sleep so that way we don't mess anything up. Goodness gracious. This has been a very successful playthrough. Oh, it's foggy outside. Okay, so things that we really need to think about next is getting our hands on some lamps. Lamps are going to be very important for us. If a person doesn't like pickles for a burger, what would be a good substitute? Nothing. There is no substitute for pickles when it comes to putting something on a burger. They're wrong, you know. There are a lot of things that have similar textures and flavors and so on and so forth, but the key defining thing about a pickle is salt and vinegar, right? So that's going to be your breakdown of what gives you a pickle taste instead of just having straight cucumber on your burger. So in that sense, there is no true replacement to pickles. If you don't like pickles, you're not gonna like any replacement that is out there. Now, if you want something that is similar that'll give you, you know, a different experience, then to answer that more effectively, I would tell you banana peppers are good. So banana peppers are probably a solid option in that case, right? Next to banana peppers, I would do, what else would I do if I think about it? Because, like I said, there's no real, banana peppers is probably it. My head kind of told me, what about olives? But it's like, no, you wouldn't put olives on a burger. No matter what type of burger you're eating. So let's just be honest about that. Meat or otherwise. No. You don't replace pickles. So you've got banana peppers or pickles. That's it. I think that's pretty much it. Yep. But, and I am going to say this but real quick. For those of you out there who are from various different cultures. I am a Westerner. Yes. I've been around the world and seen lots of different places, majority of which is the Eastern Asian side of the house. So that said, if you have something that you replace pickles with, let me know. And we're still looking for similar object, similar taste. And I don't want you to just be like, I put Marmite on my burgers. Like, that doesn't help me. That's a sauce spread. And even then, if you put Marmite on a burger, I want to have a conversation with you. There we go. Took a whole day to read the book. Sweet. But we read the book. See? You got to commit to the process. Oh, that burger. What did it do to us? We're sitting healthy and happy. Healthy and happy. Let's go ahead and drink. Fill. Good, 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 good. We'll drop off this carpentry boat. And what's next? We need to eat. Let's eat salad this time. I've got lots of food that I don't want to start turning, and those mushrooms need to get used, so they will. There we go. Also, I like to hold on to those things, so I will use some of these seasonings, and maybe later we'll get some food going. I said food going, some foraging going for food. But the amount of mushrooms we have puts us in a position where, again, I don't like throwing out food, so. All right. We have some space to get out and get some materials. We're going to start doing some work. I never opened this? Interesting. All right, open. First up, plank. Nail. Nail, plank. So furniture and what are you? Composter. I need two more planks. I'm sorry, three more planks. Are any more planks in here? Yeah, that's over there. Wait for it, wait for it. Okay, so first let me explain. Yes, I know. I do not need a composter unless I decide to, you know, do a little bit of a, oh my goodness, words, they're not coming to me. Words. Unless I do some farming, there's no real reason for me to do it. However, making things does give us experience, so nothing wrong with also putting something together, which will give us experience for the long run. So we're at 416 after making it, puts us at 429. So disassembly, yes, gets you experience, which is good, but also creating things gets us experience. Hell, putting up planks on windows gets us experience too, by the way. Not much, but it's there. I've doubled up on most of these. Yeah. Take a look. Yeah. So again, not much, but something. Alright, so for those of you who are not used to us being here, we usually start, you know, closing up the stream around now. Now most of that has to do with the fact that yes, I said before, I'm on the East Coast, and that means I have to work tomorrow. Now, I do like to close on, you know, good note and whatnot, and we have not had anything bad. Oh, the first tree to go down. But we are in a new space, and we need to be working on our base, so that's what I'm doing for a little bit. So, just recognize that I am, after we go to sleep, literally in-game, we'll probably be calling it a night. I was listening to a YouTuber, Spoodle, recently, who was like, you know, these casuals out here. Oh no, did I break my axe? I did break my axe. Game. My axe broke. Oh no. That sucks. Anyway, casual gamers out here, you know, we get like 2 hours of zombie time in, which is true. Oh, for those of us who have, you know, the other responsibilities of life, which is unfortunate at times, I just don't get enough time to play. All right, so this would actually work for us. If I just chop down a bunch of trees and then saw them into all these planks, that's going to give me a lot of levels, it looks like. Salt logs. Still gotta remember that there are sprinters in this save. There's no way that I should stay out here like this. Now, to the statement of this area is pretty calm, remember that we are still pretty much surrounded by woods. It took us driving this road here to get here. And then on top of that, you know, we already know that there is this intersection. I have no idea what this is. But just looking at this map, this is probably all forest. So we're in a very secure spot, despite the fact we're very far away from town. The hell is that? All right, we're on the side. So yeah, you know, do I feel good about what we've done tonight on Project Zomboid? Jumping into the game with a very limited plan and working out. Yes, we got ourselves a generator for the spot. We got ourselves the Carpentry Level 3 book, which we've already read. I said Level 3, Volume 3. It allows us to speed up our, you know, skill gains, and that's going to be a major focus. We need to get to Carpentry Level 6. If we want to be able to make stairs. So once we get to that point, we'll be golden on being able to do the rest of the stuff. Problems that we need to come up with, or solutions we need to come up with. We need to get ourselves a refrigerator. We need to get ourselves a oven. And the oven situation is less important than the refrigerator. Is more important. There are a couple ways we can do that. We hit a few different houses along the way, and this is no good to us. However, these houses did have refrigerators in them, and they have, you know, ovens as well. I'm not going to do a ton of base building most likely up front, but as we move further down the line, we will be doing so. So, you know, it was a night. We killed about 100 zombies, you know, and lots of sprinters. But we're making it. We're doing well. And we had a new friend. So shout out to Wreck-It Rad for popping in and joining us and chatting for the first time. So cheers. Kobe, Sweet Pepper, it's good to see you again, my friend. I hope things are well. Kobe, hopefully you didn't die in Eve or get blown up. PRMR, as usual, number one here. So yeah, I think it's time. We're going to sleep this time before we go to bed so that when we come back on stream, we are waking up bright and early, ready to get going. But for now, I'm signing off. And I appreciate you as always. Do all the YouTube things for me. Like, comment, subscribe, blah, here on Twitch. Thank you for the follow for anybody who does later along the line as well. And I will see you in the next one. Cheers.